Would you all please rise? Has the honor of presenting our beautiful bride today. I'm giving her a chance to fuss with the train a little bit. Let me just say again how beautiful she looks. Do you agree? Yes. Is that the best you can do? Yes. There we go. That's a little better. And he looks pretty spiffy too, huh? Yes. Family and friends, my name is Bill. I want to welcome each and every one of you and thank you for being here today to witness the marriage of Brenda and Jeffrey. It's really a privilege to share a happy occasion like this. We're here not only to witness the vows and promises they're about to exchange, but also to wish them the very best that life has to offer in their future together. And I say these words for the first time as husband and wife, wife and husband, whichever way you want to say it. So I look for readings that are appropriate and meaningful. And because I've been married almost 45 years, and when I read through this reading, it meant something to me, I thought it would be appropriate to share with you. It's called The Art of a Good Marriage, and it's by Wilfred Arion Peterson. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, I love you. He says at least once a day, I say maybe more than that. It's never going to sleep angry. It's at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with a honeymoon. It should continue throughout all of the years. It's having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It's standing together, facing the world, forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It's doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It's speaking words of appreciation, demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's not looking for perfection in each other. We all know that that doesn't exist. It's cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It's having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which each of you can grow. It's a common search for the good and for the beautiful. And I wish I could lay claim to this next statement, but I can't. It's still his. It's establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It's not only marrying the right person, it's being the right partner. Now we come together not to mark the start of your relationship, but to recognize the bond that already exists between the two of you. Throughout history, what people have found that is essential for a strong and lasting relationship is that it be founded on what we call love. All right, now, define love. There's love of animals and love of the beach and love of beautiful sunset. And then there's love of your family. And then there's love of your spouse. There's love of your partner, the person that you'll spend the rest of your life with. So in looking for something, I found two readings that I came across. The first is from Scripture, from Corinthians. Love, and it's called On Love. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, and it always perseveres. Now, this next reading is a little more contemporary by a journalist named Abigail Van Buren, commonly referred to as Dear Abby. Anybody ever hear of her? Yeah? Well, she wrote this. Love is a friendship that has caught fire. It's quiet understanding, mutual confidence, sharing, and forgiving. It's loyalty through good and through bad. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is content with the present. It hopes for the future, and it does not brood over the past. It is the day-in and day-out chronicle of irritation, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working towards common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for a great many things that you might lack. If you don't have love in your life, no matter what else there is, it's never going to be enough. So search for love, share it, and most of all, enjoy it. Now, you've gathered your whole family to be here with you today to celebrate this special day. There are also people in your lives who could not join you. As we celebrate today, we keep in our minds and our hearts the people who have left this earth in body, but certainly not in spirit. We also keep in our hearts the people who could not, for whatever reason, travel here to be here and join you today, but who we know would be wishing you well. Now there comes a time when I shut up and you talk. And so this is that time. And your vows, the words that you've chosen to say to each other, you're going to go first.
Jeff, that's loud. You are a gift. You are an absolute miracle. The universe provided me with a perfect man. It took some time for me to accept it, but with your patience and persistence, I saw that you and I have always been inevitable. Our souls must have been made with the same stardust. And I'm convinced that in all of our past lives, we always managed to find each other. I vow to be your comfort in chaos, to be your lighthouse in the dark, and to be your safest place. I vow to treat you with respect, kindness, and patience, and to love you unconditionally through the constantly changing waves of our life. You will never doubt how I feel, because I will never let a day go by where I don't make it clear that I choose you. I vow to find you in the next lifetime, just like I did before. I've loved you then. I love you now. I'll love you always.
Brenda, I'm beyond excited to be standing here with you right now on our wedding day, a day I've been envisioning and manifesting for what has felt like forever. Well, it was quite the journey, but from the moment our eyes first met, I knew my heart had found its forever home. I knew that you were my destiny and I was yours. And now it is in this home where each moment we share will only add ethereal color and warmth that will never fade. I vow to cherish and respect you, to care for you and protect you always. I vow patience and honesty, to continue to appreciate every bit of who you have been, who you are, and who you will ever become. I promise to always make you feel chosen, because in every reincarnation, in every world, in every galaxy, in a million lifetimes, I would choose you. You are my universe. I vow to always lift you up when you feel down, to make you laugh when you least expect it, and to always encourage your dreams and support your vision. I vow to be faithful, to love you unconditionally, and always be by your side through any ups and downs. Oh, a little more. Lastly, I vow to always be the man who will fight for your honor, to be the hero you've been dreaming of, and we'll live forever, knowing together that we do it all for the glory of love. Shout out Peter Cetera and Newfound Glory. You are my everything, my 11-11 wish, my forever punk rock princess, my sweet syrup pie. I could not be more honored to become your husband and have you as my wife till we are ghosts and forevermore.
Now you can stand a little closer together. There you go. The rings you're about to place on one another have a special and symbolic significance in the wedding ceremony. They're circular, having no beginning and no ending. As such, they symbolize the complete circle with one another that you form today, with no point being more important than the other, with all parts being equal and necessary to complete the circle that is to be your marriage. As you take these rings, I would have you remember that to love is to come together from the pathways of your past and to move forward hand in hand along the uncharted roads of the future, ready to risk, ready to dream, and ready to dare. And always believe that all things are possible with love, with faith, and most of all, the willingness to work hard to achieve them both. I'm going to take a small one. There you go. Jeffrey, as you place the ring on Brenda's finger, please repeat after me. I, Jeffrey, choose you, Brenda, to be my wife.
I, Jeffrey, choose you, Brenda, to be my wife.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
And forever pledge you my faith.
And forever pledge you my faith.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
Let it ever be to us.
Let it ever be to us.
A symbol of our love.
A symbol of our love.
Brenda, as you place a ring on Jeffrey's finger, please repeat after me. I, Brenda, choose you, Jeffrey, to be my husband.
I, Brenda, choose you, Jeffrey, to be my husband.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
And forever pledge you my faith.
And forever pledge my faith.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
Let it ever be to us.
Let it ever be to us.
A symbol of our love.
A symbol of our love.
Let nothing come between the love and the friendship that you pledge to each other here today, in front of your family and your friends. And in fact, take a look and just look at this lovely room of people that love you, cherish you, and are going to party with you in a few minutes. Now I'd like to offer you a blessing. Gracious God, our hearts are filled with great happiness on this wedding day of Brenda and Jeffrey. They come before you pledging their lives and their hearts to one another. Grant that they may ever be true and loving, living together in such a way as to never bring heartbreak into their marriage. Temper their hearts with kindness and help them to be sweethearts, helpmates, friend and guide, and together may they meet the cares and problems of life more bravely. May their home truly be a place of love and harmony where your spirit is ever present. Bless their wedding day and walk beside them throughout all of their life together. And we all say, Amen. Inasmuch as you, Jeffrey, and you, Brenda, pledge your faith to each other here in front of your family and friends, by the authority vested in me by the state of California, with the love and the trust of your family and friends, I now pronounce you husband and wife, wife and husband. I know you've been practicing for a while for this, so please share your first kiss as husband and wife. Usually I have to tell them that there's a 5-second rule, but I didn't think I needed to tell them that. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor, my privilege to introduce to you for the very first time the new Mr. and Mrs. Seraphine. But it's just a
But it's just a sweet, sweet fantasy, baby.